What is going on YouTube? This is Ninstarverse on again once again, and welcome to another episode of Ninstarport. This is where we share our thoughts, ideas, and anything really about upcoming or already released video game. We're at part 3 of our Super Smash Bros. Shenanigans, and with me is Sapphire Mayo.
Hey, this is Sapphire Mayo.
And Mechanized Oshawa.
Hello.
And Shadownade.
What's going on, guys? Been a while.
Speak up, buddy.
And
hey, hey.
I can speak as loud as I want to.
And Baron.
Hello.
And newcomer D Hizzle.
Hey guys.
He's new. Very, very new.
We would make an opening cutscene for him similar to Smash Brothers, you know, in that fashion, but
he's the newcomer.
Us are animators.
He's very shy.
D Hizzle shies into battle. Okay. Alrighty, so we are continuing on with our Super Smash Bros. Discussion. You just watched videos of Comic-Con, and now our thoughts of the characters that have been announced. So now we're going to go continue on with this crazy list with the characters that were previously in Smash Bros., but not announced as of yet. And, of course, newcomers or whatnot that we're looking forward to. So, Sapphire Mayo, you have the list, so shall we get started?
Yes, so the next character that we're going to talk about is Jigglypuff.
Jigglypuff!
Yeah, as for me, I honestly couldn't care less if Jigglypuff comes back. What is your guys' thoughts?
Well, most likely Jigglypuff will come back.
I think it needs to stay within
tradition. Yeah, she's been there since N64.
Yeah, it's part of the rule set now. You don't mess with the original 12.
I don't know, I'm pretty
sure. And the fairy typing. Come on, fairy typing.
I'm pretty sure that's not an option in the Smash Brothers setting, but whatever.
Well, it'd be kind of like if you took away Ness or Captain Falcon.
Oh, don't want to do that.
You don't touch the Falcon.
No, exactly.
He's just speaking of Falcon, I actually did find the F-Zero anime just today. Like, I was just scrolling through and I found it. So I was like, so I guess they need to keep Captain Falcon because he's also got an iconic anime, I reckon. So
yeah. However, though, Captain Falcon, as we already know, is in. However, though, D. Hizzle brought up a good point, Ness. Is it Ness next on our list?
He better be.
Yeah.
Yes.
So there's Ness and Lucas.
Yeah.
On the list.
Lucas is back.
No, he hasn't come back yet. No.
Really?
No.
We don't know if he's coming back, but I think Ness has a bit of chance.
Yeah, I couldn't care for Lucas's return, in all honesty, but Ness's return.
And there's huge hints of Ness returning. Like, there's still Mr. Satin and the Franklin badge, you know.
We're still going to get a Mother series representative.
That's right, and there's tons of Mother like references already that's been announced in the new Smash, so one of the two is definitely going to come back. Question is, will both? I don't know. However, though, did you guys want both back or just one?
I would say both.
Yeah.
Look, Earthbound is an amazing series, and it really does need a lot more attention.
But remember, as you did say, though, remember how, like, you were saying about that each Smash Bros. They've, like, increased it from two characters to three, and then they're not going to go, and they go bigger each time, if you've noticed? I think that's what they'll do with this one, if that's the case, if you know what I'm saying.
That's right. So I do strongly support that probably both of them would be coming back, but with all honesty, it wouldn't faze me if one or both come back. Either way, I'd like both.
At least one of them come back.
Ness and Lucas. So, yeah. They were good, great additions, and hopefully, one of them will come back. Just question is which one, and if not, both of them. Hopefully, that'll be great. What's the next character on the list, by the way?
Next on the list is Rob.
Rob, the robot, huh?
Yes, our robotic buddy. I know one of our friends is a very good Rob user. Fortunately, she's not here with us, but what do you guys think? You think Rob should come back?
I'm not too fazed.
Me neither.
Look, the reason why I like Rob in Game & Watch is just it's a subtle nod to things that, you know, Nintendo attempted.
It is a piece of Nintendo's history.
Exactly, and that's why I do like them. They have that history and the historical aspect to them.
Mm-hmm. And Rob is came and gone in a few other titles such as Mario Kart DS. He even made several appearances in Smash Bros. Brawl, other than being a playable character. And yeah, he's
Zero?
He gets around. So, Rob, I don't see why he would get cut. He's a unique character. So, I think Rob
will
stay. However, though, you did bring up another character, Game & Watch. We don't know if Game & Watch is coming back or not yet.
Yes, so Game & Watch. He appeared in the Pac-Man trailer, yet we have not seen any page for him on the actual website. So it's only a matter of time. I'm waiting. Hurry up, Sakurai.
Freaking hell. Do you guys think he will definitely come back?
Like, I reckon he will. I reckon he will.
Oh, shit. He's coming back. He better come back.
He was teased. Oh. As if they haven't revealed him yet. I still don't get it. Why tease him and not reveal him straight away, you know?
Yeah.
Because they already revealed, what, Pac-Man and Palutena that same day. Give them time. They don't want to just unleash everyone at once. Otherwise, where's the fun of that?
Oh, everything will go Werehog. Alright, I get it. Alrighty. However, though...
See what you did there.
But
I just realized what you were saying.
Yes?
Some of you guys are slow, but you're too slow.
Oh, god damn it.
Should we move on to another character?
That's right. Another character that was back in the Melee days was, Mewtwo and Dr. Mario. I know Mechanized Oshawott is especially a big fan of those two characters.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you
think? I still really want to see a Dr. Mario costume change for Mario.
That's right. And being that a bunch of costume changes have been announced... And makes sense if Mario brings his Dr. Mario outfit. Probably even his Sunshine outfit from, well, Sunshine. But what about your thoughts, Mechanized Oshawa? You were a big fan of both those characters.
Yeah, I really do like Dr. Mario and Mewtwo. I prefer Dr. Mario mainly for the power aspect. It would be nice if it was a costume change, like how it is in Project M. Yeah, I really hope that's something that they do. And as for Mewtwo... If it's not in, I will personally castrate Sakurai myself.
You really have it for Sakurai, don't you?
Oh, yes.
You really do.
Oh, wow. Sakurai is good at, you know, slapping a lot of fans across the faces, so... Well, I don't blame him, honestly. Mechanized Oshawott, I don't blame you. You know? But, however, though... I would love to see Mewtwo back. He would be great. Like,
as nice as he is as a character, I just kind of hard to have him in there while with Greninja and Lucario in at the same time.
Yeah, but Mayo.
Yeah.
Fighting beats dark. Dark beats psychic.
You're really going through this right now.
Fighting. There's room.
But Lucario's a steel type, so that's going to take neutral damage.
No, steel doesn't resist psychic anymore.
No, I think it's just ghost and dark.
We'll save this for a Pokemon discussion another day, please, girls.
Nope.
Alrighty. However, continuing on with the Melee roster was our Zelda representatives, which is Toon Link,
yes.
Or Young Link, I should say, and Ganondorf. That's right. Well, definitely, there's probably no hopes for Young Link. No hopes whatsoever.
No.
It's still possible as a costume change for Toon Link. Just saying. It's a possibility.
That's probably
true. Regular Link.
That's right. However, though, Ganondorf, what do you guys think?
Yes. We'll be back.
Yes.
Yeah, just with no Captain Falcon moveset.
We need to bring back the Dorf.
Yeah. Chatternade, what do you think, being you're a huge Zelda fan?
Oh, look, I have no doubt in my mind that Ganondorf would return, but I wouldn't mind seeing a new Zelda villain take his place. That's just me.
I wouldn't mind seeing the they need to just, like, pretty much unleash the Ganon cannon, pretty much with Ganondorf.
That's one way to put it.
Can.
As long as he gets a nice makeover with his moveset, then he should be a good character.
The characters have customizable movesets, don't they?
Yeah.
That's right.
Give him the sword.
There is a giant fear that he will share the same customizable movesets as Captain Falcon as well, so... Hopefully they change Ganondorf. After all, they did change several other characters like we discussed before. Like, Link has been slightly changed a little bit, and now makes Toon Link and Link a little bit separate from each other, which we brought up in the last discussion. However, though, let's hope they do the same with Mewtwo... With Captain Falcon and Ganondorf.
Yes, that would be hopeful.
Would you like me to move on to the final Melee exclusive characters? Roy and Pichu. What are your thoughts?
Pichu. I've got to say Pichu right now.
Pichu was... I liked Pichu. I definitely preferred Pichu over Pikachu back in my Melee days. other than the fact that he kept zapping himself. That was a big letdown.
Yeah, well, I was trying to keep it true to the anime, which was stupid. The anime is the worst thing that happened to Pokemon since.
However, though, like, Pichu felt like he had more solid hits than Pikachu did. So, surprisingly, coming from a little powerhouse. But, yeah, I don't think Pichu will come back.
Costume change, however.
Yeah, costumes.
Yeah,
exactly. They can have the Notu Pichu.
Oh, no, that'd be cool.
Yeah,
I'd like that.
That would be pretty cool. That would be cool at all. What about, what was the last character? Roy.
Poor Roy, honestly. Poor fucking
Roy. We've already got four characters from Fire Emblem. I don't think we're going to get Roy, unless he's a costume change.
Yeah, that's a long shot for Roy, unfortunately. Roy was our boy, but not anymore, unfortunately. Well, not for Sakurai's either.
My boy.
So, there's no hopes for Roy, unfortunately, guys, I'd say. But, well, moving on to the... continuing on with the Brawl list.
We'll move on. So, how about Falco and Wolf?
Falco's got a good shot. Wolf, I would say one of them's got to go. At least one of them. Yeah. Don't get me wrong, all three characters was great, but just seeing them having identically the same moves was a...
Landmaster!
was a big joke and a half. So, I'm hoping that one of them gets cut and replaced with a new Star Fox representative, but for the meantime, we're talking about these two. So, which out of the two do you guys think would you prefer to have back?
Falco, if you want to say that he's been already there for two games running, but Wolf, because he just seems a bit more different to Fox.
Yeah, I would
but
say
they still need a bit more changes, though.
That's actually a good argument. I agree.
However, though, this is what I feel like. I feel like they can still make those changes that Wolf had and apply them to Falco. You know what I mean? So it may change up Falco a bit from previous games, but it'll make a little more fitting, well, a little more understandable in terms of this clone aspect. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yes.
Sure.
So merge Falco and Wolf together as kind of one character, like Fusion.
Fusion, ha!
Exactly. Wolfco. They call it Wolfco. But yeah, so that would be great. And honestly, they're gonna change, they have to change Falco's Final Smash. They have to. It's already been confirmed that Fox comes back with the Landmaster, so hopefully Falco will have his R-Wing instead.
Yes, that would be nice, actually.
Or at least get his other... minions or henchmen over, like Leon and Pigma, or something.
So, there we go. As long as they change Falco's Final Smash, I'll be really happy with that. But, sticking by the rule that we kind of came up with, as we spoke to with Ness and Lucas, if they cut one, they have to add back one. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, that only leaves a few more candidates, and I've got my eye set on one of them. So, if you guys ain't
Crystal?
Aware... Yeah, stop jumping to conclusions, woman. Alright, but if you guys aren't aware, yes, there's many other Star Fox representatives. And one has been a favourite alongside Wolf back in the Brawl days, so... Wolf,
absolute favourite. Cool. I think everyone wants this person in.
That's right, because of the
Flippy Toad.
Yeah,
oh, God. Yellow Toad.
Moving on to the next characters...
So even though we've got quite an abundance of sword characters, I still think Meta Knight might have a good chance of coming back.
Yeah, it's part of Masahiro Sakurai's work, so why not?
Well, with the Kirby lineup, it's the three musketeers. Kirby, DDD, Meta Knight. You can't have two and then not have the other. It's like having Link, Zelda, and no Ganondorf. You don't complete the Triforce.
That's right. So, I'd say Meta Knight's come back. He was a unique character. As long as they nerf him down a little bit, I'll be
He's probably going to get lots of nerfs. The nerfs.
Definitely. However, though, I'm for one Meta Knight coming back. You guys agree?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
He was a fun character to use.
Yes, he was. Well, that was easy. Okay. What's the next character on the list?
So our next Brawl character that appeared was Snake.
Snake?
Snake?
Snake.
Snake! Oh boy. What's gonna happen to our beloved Snake?
Not in. Cut. Gone. Well, fuck off.
I mean, if he does come back, that means we'll have not three, but four third-party characters.
And I can already think of a better third-party character from Konami that would actually fit the Smash universe a lot better than Snake could, but...
We'll talk about later.
Yeah, I think Snake, he was an alright character, but I just thought he just didn't fit in that well.
Yeah.
With the rest of the characters.
Same. I think that, you know, despite him being an okay character in the competitive scene, he did not really go so well when it came to just the standard stuff. Like
he stood out like a sore thumb.
Yeah, he's like a pink turd in the haystack sort of thing, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Poor character, but I'm not too fussed if he doesn't make it back.
That's right. But however, though, I will just throw this out there: if it wasn't for Snake, we wouldn't have Sonic, Mega Man, or Pac-Man in these games today. So we do owe Snake, but.
Thanks, Snake.
I wouldn't mind if he comes back or not, but it's up to Sakurai in the end. But, you know, Snake opened the window, which I am very grateful for. I'm very grateful of Hideo Kojima begging Sakurai to put him in. Yeah, so thank you, Hideo Kojima, for opening the windows for Smash Brothers. So there we go, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, so next on the list, I'm pretty sure this guy's coming back. Wario.
No shit.
Ashley's in. It's also under Wario on the eShop. Let's just say he's in and move on.
Yeah, he's got a very good bet. Do you think he might change quite a bit?
Just fix his
previous...
Wario waft. That's all I want.
I think they'll honestly, his default will be his actual overalls, and with his Wario wear as an alternate costume this time, like a Gabriel Ferrer, you know. Look.
Yeah, and as well, I think they need to change his walk.
His walk?
Yeah, you know how, like, right.
He's very centered. The way he's animated is very similar to in the style of his WarioWare series.
Yeah.
Do you think he'll be more of an emphasis on his other Wario games, like Wario Land?
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Yeah, Wario Land. And with that being said, you know, he is one of the second favorite characters I do like. You know, and I wouldn't want him to be, you know, just, like, put on as some sort of, like, another Wario. I don't want him depicted as, you know, more as a WarioWare character, not recognized for his old games like Wario Land.
Indeed.
Yeah.
That's right. And I really would hope Wario comes back, and I would like him to see his running animation just change. That's it.
Yeah, pretty much. But, you know, if he doesn't come back, I won't be sad, really.
Yeah.
I'll be sad. Oh, actually, I will be sad, but I won't be affected as much.
That's right. And I think Wario would actually look a lot more amazing, a lot more better than he would do in this version than he did in Brawl. Like, Brawl, he kind of looked a little funny. I think he will look a lot more better this time around.
Yeah, exactly.
He was a pretty exaggerated character, and he was actually a really hilarious character to play as, so bring it on.
That's right. I still play as him, so...
That's right. So, is there any more characters left to talk about, honestly?
Yes. Let me just get a look at the list. We have the dynamic duo, Ice Climbers.
Ooh, wow.
Very good chance of getting being back, because we did see the polar bear enemy in Smash Run.
Oh, yeah, then...
But the problem is, they might be changed from Ice Climbers to Ice Climber, because I remember way back in the early development stages, I remember a post from Sakurai saying there was trouble coding the follow command from the other Ice Climber on the 3DS version.
That'd be weird, because they've managed to do it on Melee, on a GameCube.
Yeah, but
Nintendo Wii.
It just takes more time.
No, more time, and it's more the fact that, you know, you're dealing with a portable platform instead of a handheld console. There's less work. Like, I'm not a programmer or anything like that, but
well,
I think...
the 3DS should be powerful enough.
Yeah, but I don't think it outpowers the GameCube.
It probably would be, but I would say it's, more on the side that, you know, what if you're playing multiplayer or online? That's when things might get a little problem with the Ice Climbers, especially on the 3DS version. So, I would say, yeah, I think I was the one that brought it up to Mechanized Oshawott that It might change to Ice Climber, but if they go to the standalone Ice Climber, it'll be more of a reference of the original Ice Climbers, because you were versing against each other, not working together. And on top of that, it will buff up the original Ice Climber on his own, so...
Yeah, and we'll get rid of that infinite grab shit, so...
That's right.
I don't know if anyone can do infinite grabs in the new game.
I think they'll work something out.
I honestly think it'll be better if Ice Climber is on his own. Just, you know what I mean? And I think he'll probably be buffed up very well.
I'm not too fussed with if there was a change to that, but I think it'll still be good to have the Ice Climbers or Climber back.
That's correct. Yeah. And as an alternative costume, from Nana to Popo.
Yeah.
Seems legit.
Simple as that. So I don't think Ice Climbers is going to get cut, no way, but it will be changed. For this sake. Any other characters left? Or is that all?
Well, the final veteran characters to cover now is Squirtle, Ivysaur, and Pokemon Trainer.
Pokemon Trainer is kind of technically in the game, because you're now the Pokemon Trainer with Charizard.
That's correct, and Lucario if you want to throw it in that too, but however though.
Maybe Greninja?
Come on, why you got so much
hate
for Lucario?
So, I think Squirtle and Ivysaur might be unfortunately cut because of the autonomy now from Charizard.
Especially Squirtle, but there still might be some form of hope for Ivysaur, because we don't have a grass type in the game.
True.
Very true. However, though, there's a massive rumor going around that since we got Greninja based on the third evolution water type, we got a Charizard based on the third evolution of fire type. Word has been going around of a newcomer maybe coming, maybe approaching for Pokemon. But it's looking a little bit iffy at the moment, being that we already have four Pokemon representatives.
Well, bear in mind, we have five Mario representatives, and then back in May and Brawl, we had six. So, that argument's blown out of the water.
That is indeed correct.
We got four Fire Emblem characters, so, yeah.
Yeah, two to four.
Very true. So, I guess that wraps up all the veterans, and we're talking about the next discussion, which will roll on straight away. But word has it that we're going to get the whole roster revealed on August 12th. Is that correct, guys?
Yes, that is certainly correct.
Well, round about next week. Well, not next week, next month.
But next month.
I wish next week.
Nope. Not far away. About 2 weeks, maybe. By this time this video gets uploaded, maybe a day or two. But you know what I mean? However, though.
There is something I would like to say, though. Apparently, we're going to know what the starting roster is even sooner. Japan is actually holding a tournament for the 3DS final version, and they will start with the starting roster.
Final?
Yeah.
Yeah,
Japan's getting a few tournaments, 3DS tournaments.
Switching development, actually. I mean, look, it was just recently you said that Hyrule Royce gone out of development, and that's due for September 20 or something here. Whereas in Japan, we got Smash Bros. 3DS due for September 13. But something other.
That's right, okay. That would sort of make sense.
Mm-hmm. So the game, the Smash Bros. 3DS is essentially near complete. So the whole roster might get revealed, well, at least the starting roster, very shortly. It most likely be all the characters that's already revealed, but it could be another one here or two. However though, guys, this is about the remaining characters to be revealed. So who do you think is yet to come back and will come back, or newcomers?
Ooh.
Well, we've already covered all the veterans, whether or not they'll be back or not. So do you want to mention any newcomers that we really want to see?
So this rolls on to continuing on to our grass type discussion. So I think Mechanized Oshawa brought this specific Pokemon up before. Did you want to fill up?
Well, basically with Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire on the horizon, It's most likely it'll be a Hoenn starter, especially considering that Charizard's at the very beginning of the Pokemon and well, the Pokemon arc, and then we got Greninja who's at the very end. So having Sceptile, who's
Smackbang.
Yep, Smackbang in the middle.
And then he's got his Mega Evolution for a final smash.
Exactly.
Yeah
brand new.
True.
Rust Dragonfly.
He seriously turns into a Christmas tree, I swear.
I'll crack up.
However, though, so Sceptile has been the huge word going around character, especially for a Pokemon representative. I would like to see that. That would be nice. It would be a very fast and powerful character, if you ask me.
I like Sceptile.
Yeah, Sceptile, yes.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's we don't know anything yet, so we'll see about that.
Only
time will tell.
I'd like to point out that I'm going by the Smash Bros. Direct, and they did this whole trophy quiz thing. Do you guys remember that?
Yes.
And yeah, they showed, I think it was Taki from... Was it Tiki or Taki? One of those, I think it was Tiki, from Fire Emblem. And
It was Tiki.
And then we had Pseudo Palutena. And we also had Fi, and I was thinking they symbolize a newcomer for each series. And we've got our newcomer from Fire Emblem, and our newcomer from Kid Icarus. So Fi was there, part of that trophy quiz. Could that symbolize or foreshadow a newcomer for the Zelda series?
Well, if it's gone by, well, that, I only can think of, well, two games that could potentially represent this. Maybe even three. Maybe even three. Skyward Sword, A Link Between Worlds, and Wind Waker HD.
Oh, there is actually a Wind Waker HD level.
Wow, that I did not know about.
You guys have to look through the new screenshots, and you can see Lucina and Mario fighting on what looks to be a Wind Waker island with the mailbox in the background.
Huh. Just want to say, if there was going to get another Legend of Zelda character, can I just say one thing?
Is it Tingle?
The Groose is loose.
Oh, the Groose. The Groosinator.
Yes.
The Groosinator.
I'm looking at the Wind Waker screenshot. Well, the Wind Waker level. Could that possibly mean Toon Zelda or Tetra as a character?
Well, that's what I was leaning towards too. I'm really hoping Tetra gets in.
Forbidden Four.
So yeah, I think Tetra would be amazing. Like, I just didn't see her work, being a pirate and all, you know? She could just loose cannonballs and shit. But what about you guys think? Like, again, it was Fi that was kind of being representative, so it might even be Skyward Sword.
No, well, it could even be Hyrule Warriors. I mean, we could end up with maybe Lana.
Lana would be fucking sick.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's some pretty cool tricks
that we
see. And we got Midnat as an assist trophy. So,
that's...
Yeah.
So, it could be anybody. Well, it could be the Groose is loose, or it could be Gear.
Yes.
Yep. Anyone from Link Between Worlds you could possibly see happening or nah?
I would see Zelda as a costume change as the most.
Toon Zelda.
Yeah, I'll go with Toon Zelda for Wind Waker.
I would probably lean towards more Tetra for Wind Waker.
Yeah, but she would definitely be different.
She'd definitely be different. That's right. So that's why I and also Tetra is just badass. She's just badass. however though. Other characters that we just I'll see as a newcomer. This is going back now to the Star Fox discussion that we had a little earlier, which
I already spoiled.
Yes, you did, woman.
Sorry.
I strongly believe, and this is my most number one requested character, Crystal. I'd say Crystal deserves her spot in Smash. She was almost tied with both with Wolf for Brawl, so that's how close she was. Making Brawl originally, and since Wolf was a big, big slap across the face, a lot of Star Fox fans and Smash Bros. Fans, there's a good chance Wolf gets cut and Crystal comes in. So,
yes.
What do you guys think?
I really think, Crystal's moveset is definitely very plausible in Smash Bros. Game. Only issue I have is it's just been a while since we've seen her. In a Star Fox game.
That is true. Like
you could say the same with Wolf.
But then we did have Star Fox 3D for the 3DS.
Mm-hmm.
So that gives us potential.
Yep. And being that Nintendo has teased a new Star Fox game on the way, it might just bring some little more hope towards Crystal. And again, sticking by that same format that we're not going to cut off any numbers of that particular franchise. So since we have three Star Fox representatives, we have to stick with at least three or more. So I'd say Crystal's got a shot. A good, good shot.
Yes.
What about you? What about you guys? Shadowmade, yep. Recognize Oshawa?
I reckon.
Yeah, I'd say so. I've met Baron and stuff on this one.
Mm. Yeah. Recognize Oshawa?
Yeah, Hizzle? Look, I agree. Yeah, I agree. Crystal needs to come in. Or, you know, someone that can fill the shoes from Star Fox.
Like Slippy Toad?
Oh, God, no.
Help me!
Alrighty. What other characters can you guys see? Like, we're nearing the end of the newcomer list, apparently, as Sakurai said, at least for videos. So we might get another newcomer hero 2 before the game is released.
And
but there's stuff more to be unlockable or revealed on, of course, August 12th. So I'd say we got at least another good 3 or 4 more newcomers.
Yeah, before the answer.
Yeah.
I would say so.
Because we're currently at 39 in our roster.
That's correct. And I'm saying the roster's leaning towards 50 characters.
They already said that they're trying to achieve 50, so that's already covered in a way.
Yes. And I think we've got a total of 12 newcomers, I think, now?
I think so, yeah.
That's right.
So, there's a few characters I'd really like to see. I'd like to see another Sonic character representative.
That's Sick. Right.
Yeah, that'll be...
Does anyone else think so?
Unfortunately, we already know that Shadow makes the ultimate assist trophy.
God.
Yes.
It won't be Shadow if that's the case.
Hey, Jordan, will it be any use?
I believe when Sakurai is involved, it's no use.
I'd say, how about Knuckles?
Sonic and Knuckles! Holy shit, that'd be sick!
Wait, the old Knuckles or the Beefcake Knuckles?
I would say Beefcake Knuckles would be freaking sick. Yeah!
Like Boom Knuckles.
Yeah.
Oh,
however, though, yes, it would either be a huge debate between Tails and Knuckles right about now, since it's definitely not Shadow. So, my vote would go to Knuckles.
Actually, what about Eggman?
Possible.
No. He's not suitable as a fighter.
Unless he's like a stage hazard.
I would have liked to see like Death Egg as a level or something.
That'd be cool. We still have not yet to see what Sonic's 3DS level would be, so we don't know as of yet.
Yeah.
However, though, I would like to throw this out. I strongly believe that how all levels have boss battles, so some levels will have boss battles.
Yep.
I believe some of the Deadly Six will appear on the Windy Hill Zone stage.
Makes sense.
That's deadly stereotypes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna beat you like a drum!
fuck.
However, though, that's if we're looking at Sonic refs, do you guys think maybe Mega Man might get one or not?
Proto Man? I don't know.
No, Mega Man's already got... It's been confirmed that Dr. Wily's castle will also appear on the 3DS stage. On the 3DS.
That's correct.
Yeah, so I don't think there'll be another one. Although it'd be cool to see that.
We got an assist trophy for Electman.
Yeah. So, I don't know. I really wanted to see Proto Man in some shape or form.
Ooh, what about Bass as an assist trophy?
Yeah. Bass would be cool.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
That'd be interesting. We'll also throw this out. There was this post that Sakurai made about Mega Man's Final Smash, saying that these characters look so detailed that we had to make them into trophies, right? I think, well, that message has two things. Well, first thing is what he actually said, and the second thing is being that they're so detailed, and he was really hyping it up that it was so detailed, that all those five Mega Mans might be alternate costumes. What do you guys think?
Possible. That's like...
That'd be pretty epic.
Yeah, but that would be like going to the Rayman thing again, because he said something very similar about Ubisoft giving them like the 3D model for Rayman.
I would love Rayman to be playable, but I just think
maybe
not, it won't happen.
I don't know if it's true or not, but apparently they changed his trophy. Because he was looking dopey. in the original one.
Yeah. I don't know. So I guess we'll find out soon enough. But that leads to another question. Ubisoft, since we now know they're involved, do you guys think maybe Ubisoft might get a rep?
I would love to.
It would be Rayman if they get a rep. Mate.
It's going to be FZO.
Yes, or Glowbox, please.
Please. Just take all over again.
How about this? I know that those Raven Rabbits get around.
I wouldn't want to see one of them.
Please. Trophy, yes. Playable character, God, no.
Yeah. So, I would like to actually see a Raven Rabbit assist trophy. That would be actually pretty funny.
You just run around with toilet plunges or something. I don't know.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's my thoughts on that. Any other characters you guys see? Again, we are nearing the end of the roster, so since we're currently sitting on 39, and if there's a total of 50, you know, some of them being veterans, some of them are newcomers, so...
How about a Rhythm Heaven character?
It's gotta be the main girl. It's gonna be the girl from Beat to Beat. Not the chorus man. Fuck the chorus man.
We did discuss that about with the Chrom announced the Chrom troll, let's just say that. That Tipstar is now confirmed to be wrong, being that Chrom is not playable. So what about then if it was simply mistaken, what about Shulk?
It would be nice to have him in there because Xenoblade Chronicles was a very good series and very was followed quite a bit.
Yep.
It would be good to have a representation.
And with a new one coming out as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
X.
Yeah. Xenoblade Chronicles X.
Is Shulk even part of the new one though?
Oh, there's a few hat tips to him. Like there's this female character who has a hairpin like the Monado, which is the sword that Shulk uses.
That red sword.
Yeah. But I would like to see him in or some form. But
or maybe just any character from Chronicles.
I don't know. I don't think he's got a name yet.
However, though, I don't know. Honestly, if you ask me, it's still too soon for a Xenoblade representative. But I could be wrong. But hopefully, I'm just getting sick of all the sword characters. That's all I'm saying.
But then add more monkeys, like Dixie Kong, or
Cranky Kong,
Monkey Kong.
Yeah, I could see that
happening. Okay, Rule, if you want to do something a bit different.
Scrooge McDuck.
I could see Dixie Kong or King K. Rool kind of happening, but what do you guys think? Do you think King K. Rool's got a chance?
Nah. There's been so much talk about him, I don't think he's going to make it.
Not only that, King K. Rool hasn't been, you know, big.
He hasn't made an appearance.
You know,
actually, he did appear in Super Mario Sluggers, and he has appeared in Jungle Climber and King of Swing, which were handheld games, which were kind of overlooked Donkey Kong games.
That's right. And
so
also,
he has appeared before, but it's still been a while.
Yeah, and on top of that, what kind of hints a little more to K. Rool being in, Smash in some way, shape, or form, is the Kremlins in Smash Run.
Yeah, buddy.
So yeah, the Kremlins are in Smash Run as well, so... Just like the polar bear, just like everything else.
How do we have the tickies are in? Screw the tickies. Need more snowmads.
Yeah. So, any other characters you guys suggest?
Well, just for Konami, because we were talking about it earlier, one character I thought might really suit, Smash is Simon Belmont from Castlevania.
Oh wow.
And the reason why I say Simon Belmont is because of Captain N the Game Master, honestly.
That would make sense, being that Kid's in the game, Mega Man's in the game.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I don't think we'll get Captain N, and I don't think we'll get Princess Lana, but, you know, if fans of the show would probably, you know, have a little smile on their face if they had Belmont.
That's right.
And I do think Belmont would be a very unique character to see.
With the whip and everything, and he's also got his different items at his disposal.
Exactly.
So he's very viable for a moveset.
And his stage, Dracula's Castle. Dracula. No, I was gonna say it could be like Simon's Quest, where halfway through the thing, the game just pauses and says, "It's a bad night to have a curse."
Oh, that's terrible.
Yeah.
However, though, yeah, I would like to see that. Just it would be a good knot to the Captain N series, which is, well, I liked it. I love Captain N. That was great. But
the game master.
That comes down to if there's going to be more third party, honestly. Alrighty. However, though, any more characters, guys, or should we start wrapping this up?
Well, one rumor that's been going around, seeing as it's Nintendo now has exclusive rights to the sequel to this game, how about Bayonetta?
Ooh.
Would be nice.
I would love to see that. It would add a lot
more female representation.
More female representation. I can just imagine her coming in and saying, "Smash Brothers, let's destroy them, sisters." Something like that. I don't know.
I don't think so, sister.
You know what I mean? So, I don't know. That would be nice. And I actually brought this up with Shadownade once before. I felt like Zero Suit Samus' heels was inspired by Bayonetta.
Yeah,
definitely. So,
yeah.
What do you got?
It'd be a nice addition.
It would be a very interesting addition. I would like to see Bayonetta in, but again, she is not exactly on Nintendo just yet. You know what I mean? The game hasn't even been released yet.
Only other thing is, if Bayonetta was in there, would that impact on the game's rating? Like, you know, for teen or mature audiences?
Well, that's true, but remember, they allowed Snake in Brawl.
Oh, yeah, and Echo, pretty friendly rating.
That is pretty a valid reason, actually.
Yeah.
It can
and
just,
like you guys were saying before, yeah. Like, if Snake's gone, why not check, like, why don't we just check Bayonetta in instead?
There.
Done.
That's right, and honestly, yeah, they can just turn down Bayonetta, you know what I mean? In terms
they,
of...
They don't need it to be too sassy, just like, I don't know, because... say some witty quips and that's it.
Yeah. Mind you, her costumes are a little bit revealing.
That's true.
What about Samus in a skin tight suit?
Exactly.
At least everything's covered. You don't see the bits.
You clearly see two jugs. But yeah. I know what you're talking about, but I think that's kind of, you know, the normal. Let's just get used to that. Let's just say
how is that normal?
Normal.
No normal person has that figure.
Alright. We'll save that for another Ninstar Force, shall we? Okay. However, though, Bayonetta, I would like her in. You guys would like her in?
Definitely.
No.
Still an interesting character, yeah.
No. Baron, you said no?
No.
No? Okay, no.
It's like another snake,
however,
female.
Yeah. Oh, I see his point. I see his point, but Bayonetta is just... because she's female, she gets more rights. That's all I can say.
And you think she'd fit in more, seeing as now she is technically part of Nintendo.
Essentially. So, yeah, I guess we'll find out soon enough. Again, we'll find out the whole roster on August 12th.
Soon!
Soon. Roster even sooner. So, yeah. You guys excited?
Yep.
I'm really pumped.
Definitely pumped.
Alrighty, so I guess on that note, I think we'll end the episode off. So, my name has been Ninstar Rose, and again, with me was Sapphire Mayo.
This has been Sapphire Mayo.
Mechanized Oshawa.
This has been Mechanized Oshawa.
Please, okay. No shit.
Shadownade was with us.
Hey guys, it was fun.
Baron.
It was a pleasure talking to you guys.
And D Hizzle.
Yep, can I go home now?
Yes.
Yep,
yeah.
Go home.
Yes.
Alright, let's let him out of the basement. Let's go.
Alright, well, my name is Mr. Rose, and we are signing out.
And I'll see you.